My name is Herbert Miller, and first time I saw Father Capaun was when I was laying in a ditch, wounded.
Well, Herbert Miller was a man that was in Father Capaun's unit, and he and other men were trying to escape or trying to make it back to safety.
This soldier come down through and he stood over, he's going to shoot me. He had the gun pointed at my head.
And he said he just closed his eyes and he said he knew that the next thing that he was going to feel was a bullet going into his head.
I looked and this American come across the road.
And he said he saw an American soldier pushing this North Korean out of the way.
It was Father Capaun. He pushed the man aside. Why that soldier never shot him, I'll never know.
Army Chaplain Emil Kapaun will posthumously receive the Medal of Honor for his acts of valor during the Korean War.
I think if he were asked whether or not he wanted this award, he would probably say, heck no, that he didn't deserve the award.
He'd be humbled. He'd tell you point blank, I don't deserve it. But that's the kind of person he was.
But the men that were in the prison camp have been working for this Father Capaun to receive this award literally from the time they got out of the prison camp.
I wonder why it took so long. The man should have got it right off the bat for the things he did.
From the stories shared by his fellow soldiers to the memorials at the church where his sermons began, Chaplain Capaun's selfless service is eternal.
He was there in the prison camp for about 6 or 7 months before he passed away. 2.5 years later, when the rest of the men were freed from the prison camp, they were still speaking of Father Capaun and how he had touched their lives.
How could you forget somebody that saved your life? I was looking right up the barrel of that gun.
He was known as a soldier's chaplain.
He wasn't above us. He was one of us. But we found out later that he died, and we knew they'd killed him.